In the previous movie, we used Maya and Mudbox together to create high-resolution textures for our character Andrew. Let's now build on those skills and texture Andrew's hard hat. The hard hat mesh has already been unwrapped into sections, which have been spread out to occupy an entire UV tile and maximize our texture space. Select the hat and choose Send to Mudbox, Send as New Scene. This creates an active link between Maya and Mudbox. Increase the hat's resolution by a few levels to smooth its contours. Let's take a few minutes to sculpt and paint some wear and tear. Create a new paint layer, set its size to 1024, and format to TIFF 16-bit. Select the paintbrush tool and choose a bright yellow color. Hold down the B key and drag to dynamically set the brush size to a larger value. Similarly, hold down M and drag to dynamically set the brush strength. Note that while you can do this with a mouse, a stylus allows you better control of sculpt and paint strokes. Now create another paint layer for the protective head strap. Change the paintbrush color to dark gray. Make sure the brush size is large enough to paint the strap in one stroke. Set the mirror value to X to apply paint strokes on both sides of the strap at the same time. As you paint the head straps, the hard hat is left unaffected because it is a distinct surface. Don't worry if you paint the wrong surface by mistake. You can use the paint erase tool to fix any errors. Construction hats tend to get scratched and dirty, so let's create another paint layer to achieve this look. Select the projection tool, then pick the splattered and scratched image from the stencil tray. The stencil appears as an overlay. You can adjust its visibility via the properties window. Return to the projection tool and set its color to white. Make sure mirror is turned off, since hard hats never get dirty exactly the same way on both sides. The stencil projects onto the hat as you paint over it. As you paint, you can adjust the stencil by holding down S and following the instructions on the screen. Press Q to toggle the stencil's visibility. It now looks like Andrew's been picking up extra work shifts down at the mine. To let the base color come through this paint layer, change its blend mode to hard light and tone down its strength to 25%. The hat now looks dirty, but not yet worn out. For this, you'll create a new sculpt layer to contain these deformations. Select the Sculpt tool, then pick the Dirt 2 image from the stamp tray to load it in the brush. As you sculpt the hard hat, you'll quickly realize that you have to adjust the brush strength. Turn on stamp spacing with a distance of 50. This spreads the bumps on the hat, which gives it a more random look. Lastly, create the ambient occlusion and normal maps using the extraction method covered in the previous movie. Andrew's hard hat now has all the desired textures and is ready to be updated in Maya. However, in a sudden surprise twist, your team's art lead tells you that the project's using too much texture memory. You can reduce the texture memory footprint by sharing materials between Andrew's hard hat and his tool belt. But this means you'll have to alter the hat's UV layout to accommodate this, and they will no longer match your current textures. Does that mean all your previous work is going to be wasted? Thankfully, the answer is no. There is a way to dodge this last-minute complication. In the Maya Outliner, look for the duplicated hard hat that is currently hidden. This new hat is already unwrapped, so it shares its UV space with all other tools like the hammer, pliers, measuring tape, and so on. Select the new hard hat and add it to the current Mudbox scene. Mudbox loads the new hat in the same space as the old one. Use the Translate tool to move it somewhere you can get a better look at it. Select Maps, Extract Texture Maps, New Operation. Select Transfer Paint Layers from the Maps to Generate list. This lets you transfer paint layers from one mesh to another, independent of their UV coordinates. Add the new hat as target model and the old one as source. Since both objects have the same topology, set the transfer method to subdivision. Set the image size value to same as source and transfer all paint layers. Don't forget to move the new hat back to its original place before you send it back to Maya. Despite the change in UVs, the texture maps are preserved. Using what you've learned here, you can go ahead and texture the remaining tool belt gear in Mudbox. In the next movie, you'll learn how to use Mudbox to create facial expressions for your character in Maya.